Welcome to my channel. My name is Mildred. So my desk is very messy. So last thing that we did was I made memory decks card from this memory decks metal die. And this is a suitcase form. This one I purchased. Okay, not sponsored. I purchased with my own money at AliExpress. And there are different kinds of memory decks, in also in shapes, in sizes, in forms. So I thought to myself, I tried to do, I showed you, I made a box, a DIY box. Of course, you can use a very squared or very rectangular one, and then make cards, because I took, I have to show you. So when I put the metal die on a printed paper, I just did it like this, very snug, as you can see. So I would not waste paper to use the handle, and then afterwards I've put it to the die cutting machine, that I will cut off the handles, the paper handles, I mean. So that would be a very big waste. So I thought to myself, maybe I can do it like this, very snug, so I can waste only the sides that I will be waste. So you can see it like this. Let's see if I can show it to you. Is there a... like this? So as you can see, I've waste only the bottom side. Oh wait, I have to fold. And these sides. And there's also here one, like here. And that will just end up in the bin. So what I thought by myself, when I was looking at the app of the app, AliExpress, when I was looking after the metal die of this luggage, I thought by myself, what can you do also with this metal die? So I saw a picture that it was made like a folder, a manila folder. And I thought, that is genius, but how can I create a manila folder? Because every time when I do it like this, you will cut exactly here on the bottom. And I thought to myself, maybe if you can see it, do it, fold the paper and then press against it like this. So you, this is... So I'm grabbing this pencil and I'm doing a closer. So on this side, you see this side, that's the cutting part. That will cut through the paper. So if you fold the paper, this is the fold. So you can see this fold. And you fold is like here against the cutting, the cutting line. So it will not cut in the line itself, because you've raised it above the line here, like this. So when you put the metal die on the acrylic plate on the die cutting machine, it will not cut here. So I did it like a couple of times, and I was so excited, like, if I, when I took the paper out and I was like looking at it like this, and I thought, oh yes, I did it. So I tried another time on here, I did it again. So I thought, like, that's genius. So now I'm going, you see, I can take out the parts, and this I can also take out. This, that's a little bit waste, but of course this I'll throw away, but this I can use it for paper confetti. Let's see if I can fold it like this. You see? And it looks funny. It looks even like a bow tie or a bow. So I thought to myself, don't throw that away. You can use it like as a decoration for making a bow, like this. Sorry. So I thought to myself, you know what? Let's cut it up because I don't like the lines in here. So. So I have now like manila folders, but then of course in that particular printed paper. And it's this one is one-sided printed paper. You have also these printed paper that are double-sided, but these are one-sided. And I tried, I thought by myself, can I do it with wrapping paper? So I grabbed a Flow magazine. I'm gonna unfold it. Like this. This is wrapping paper from the Flow. So here you have, well, it's upside down. It's the camels. And on this side is the guitars and mandolins. And I've got one piece out of it. So I did that. And I want to show you why. Because that paper is specifically thin. I'm going to put it there. I'm going to look for... Sorry, I'm going to look for... I've put it somewhere here. Let's see. Oh, there. I found it. Here. So... I've made with a pencil or fine liner, like marked on the paper, so I can just cut it like exactly that space, so I don't have so much waste. So I want to do like as minimum wasteful as I can. So I have like two different. I cut it the same way. I thought to myself it's easier because. So these two paper were on top of each other and I put the die on top of it so it could run on the die cutting machine so it cut immediately two at the same time so I don't have to do it like two different times. So if you turn one round you have then one for the theme travel and one for the theme musical music. So that's what I did. I tried to do with the special road maps in book form, and I've cut with X-Acto knife here on the spine in the center of the book when you open it. I've cut it like this, and I tried. Let's see. So I'm going to explain to you how I did everything in the previous. Video vlog because that was more like I when I finished and I was uploading I thought by myself I talked way too fast. I think it's better to explain it in the second video. It's not a part two, but in the second video I'm gonna explain how I did this. So let's see. So this is the pages of that roadmap book. And I've put the metal die on the paper because I want this time, I want it with the handle on it, you see? So I put it on the paper and I took several pages at the same time. So as you can see, I don't have to do it like three times separately. I just cut it three sheets or pages at the same time. So when I... take the paper out of the die cutting machine. I grabbed it and then I was counting 1, 2, 3. Yes, I did three pages. So as you can see, it did it perfectly. You can see even the indentation. Can you see the indentation here? So it is also embossing in the paper itself. So I'm loving it. So I'm going to put it like that. I've even done a couple of times. Without the handle, so I can save, of course, as much as I can. So I thought to myself, if I grab this page and I can do it 1, 2, 3, 4 times. I can make 4 times and then 3 pages, so I can have a lot. So I can gift it to my other snail mailers friends. So it's not just for myself. I can just cut as much as I can. So that would be great. So that's the next one. But of course the page, I'm gonna show you again. So this page, when you've put like four times here, then you have on the sides like this, you have strips of paper. So left, so one long strip of paper, and I thought by myself, cut it in half like this, so you can make snippets of paper to embellish, to decorate your bullet journal, your snail mail, your pen pal, whatever you want. You can just have these snips of paper, and the other person that receives it can do like tear it apart and glue this half on the blank page to decorate it beautiful. So I thought by myself, never waste paper, because it's very precious. Paper is precious because it comes from a tree. You don't want used paper, and the rest you're gonna throw it in the bin. So I thought myself, you can use it for embellishments, decorations, but you can also make tags. But because these paper are thin, a bit flimsy, you can put it on a thin cardboard and then glue it on there and make with die cuts beautiful decorations with it. So I'm gonna put it also in the box. Like I said, I've made these folders. So that's nice. You can use whatever printed paper for this. And I thought to myself, well, is there a possibility to use vellum? And of course, put a metal die here on. And I thought to myself, yeah, it's possible. You know, you can actually use whatever paper you can have in hand and run it with to the die cutter machine. But I thought by myself, you can do it also without the metal die. Just cut a piece of paper. So I got this vellum paper, and it is from a vellum pad. I just took one sheet or a page out. I used like the whole sheet, and I folded it in half. And I thought by myself, maybe just put it through the rounder puncher, so you can have beautiful corner rounded punch instead of a sharp corner. And I do not throw this away. So I have these when I made folders, as you can see. I didn't throw this away. I have this, luckily, put it aside on the table. And I'm looking for my, I'm looking for my ruler. So I have to see the space between this side to that side. I think. Two and a quarter. And how many inches is that? This is 1 inch, and it is lesser than 1 inch. There's a half inch. I think 0.375. Well, I don't know how to say it in 3/4. Is it right? Yes, inch. And you can also use it here, like to space it out, like that. So let's see, I need like this, and you, oh, out of frame, sorry. And then with your pencil or pen, and then you draw where you want to put. Better put it on the other side, because this side has gold. Let's see. And try. Okay, then try as best as you can. You can use this punch, make a hole puncher, or you can use this kind of puncher, but you have to do it exactly at the same height. So that's the real difficult thing, like this. The reason why you need to do it, let's see, yeah, aligned on the thing is because when you do like a couple of these, like when I grab it like this, a couple of these, and it has to be on the same height, size, so it's not gonna be one up and like one up and one down, so it won't, it will be very irregular. So you have to be continuous, like meticulous in this case, so do it please properly. And I thought by myself, you can make this time, because I don't have that special puncher like here, like squared, and it will do like two holes at the same time. I don't have that special metal puncher, so for memory decks, I mean. So you have to do it, sadly you have to do it one at a time, holes in there. So I thought by myself, so this is actually the exact page, so I used the same length, but I've cut a strip here, but of course I can use the whole page like this without cutting, so I can use the front and the back for the same thing, and then put it in here. So I'm gonna push everything in the back like that. Oh, push it like that. So if I want to do this width, so it can fit in like that, so instead of making cards, I'm making folder memory decks. That's also like I said, an option, so you can keep everything in the same spot. But if you're doing a memory deck card like this, example, looking for an example. No, I don't have. So, sorry. So I have these. These are the last paper bit from a paper pad, and this is a cardboard that is thin, and this is printed paper. Well, actually it's a roadmap paper, it's also thin, and I thought by myself, just glue it on each other so you can make it very thick. So this is for example the print that you want. You can embellish and decorate with die cuts and other things, and washi tapes and stickers and that like that, and just to make it prettier. And on that side you can put information, because this memory decks cards are actually originated from the Rolodex that was used for businessmen to put the information of their clients, the names, the address of the company, the phone number, and maybe some personal information like this man loves to drink whiskey and he has a wife or a child. You can put everything on that. But because we are crafters, we don't use these kind of things, you know, information of businessmen or business companies. We use these memory dex cards to put, for example, you can make it with other things, like you can use a pizza box and cut with a pair of scissors a piece of that, and then with your specific memory dex metal die, it doesn't have to be this one, but just a memory dex metal die, and then put it on the that piece of little piece of paper or cardboard of the pizza box, and you run it to the die cut machine, because you don't have you it's not possible to put the whole pizza box, empty pizza box, through the die cutter machine. So you just cut a piece out, so you can put it on an acrylic plate and run it to the die cutter machine. So you have the beautiful illustration of your pizza. So you can, because pizza boxes are very sturdy, you make these special cards and then put the card in there with the illustration of the pizza box. And then you write your own recipes for cooking. So that's also a thing that crafters can do. Like, hey, I want a special DIY box. I make it myself and use these memory dex cards to write in recipes. So I don't like to have it written in books, but you can just have these cards and just grab and take and watch at the back, like how to make pizza dough, how to make the toppings, etc., etc. Sometimes you can even do like desserts or even like main course. How do you say it? Dessert. You can make the whole list on there, or you can use it also for.